Hey everyone, so I wanted to take a look at Drake's display at the Expo here today, and they've got a lot of ships that are very useful in the game right now, so these are some good ones to rent if you just want some ships to do some missions in. It also looks like they've got some holo viewer models that we have seen before, but they are of pretty cool upcoming ships, so those will be fun to look at too. Off to the left here, we can start with this pretty odd looking ship. This is the Herald. It's the starter data running ship, but knowing Drake, it's probably also going to be used for hacking. It's got a pretty cool looking interior. Definitely reminds people of something like a FBI van that could be used to monitor people or do a bit of snooping. And it's also very fast in a straight line with its massive rear thrusters. And yeah, hopefully it'll be useful once we get some hacking gameplay or data running gameplay. Over here is the Buccaneer, and it's a light fighter, but that's only because it's not too heavily shielded or armored. Its weapons loadout is definitely enough to put it in the medium fighter class, but yeah, it's very fast, pretty nimble, and holds a lot of weapons for its size. This over here is the Caterpillar. This was the best cargo ship in the game for a while, but the C2 recently came in and has more capacity and is a bit faster in atmosphere, so at the moment that's better. But this eventually will be getting some modularity for its bays, which will allow it to be probably a bit more flexible than something like the C2. Unfortunately, they have raised its price recently, which is kind of odd since they haven't mentioned any progress being made on that modularity functionality, but hopefully we'll see that sooner rather than later, if that's any indication. And then over here we have all of the Cutlass variants. This here is the Cutlass Red. It trades most of the cargo capacity that you find in the Black for the lowest tier medical beds, which are basically just meant to stabilize patients. Unfortunately, they didn't really add much gameplay to these in this patch, but I hope when medical gameplay gets more developed, this will be a very useful ship in allowing you to prolong the lifespan of someone who's sustained some injuries, or maybe even treat minor injuries. In the middle here, we have the Cutlass Black. This is a great all-around ship. It has a lot of weapons, it's got a turret, and it's got a pretty reasonable amount of cargo capacity, and that cargo space can also be used to haul vehicles. So it's just a great size for letting you do a lot of the missions that are currently in the game, and it's not too cumbersome or large that it's a pain to fly around. And then the last one we have over here is the Cutlass Blue. This is the sort of law enforcement variant of it. It's even got the police flashers, and it's also got a quantum enforcement device. I don't believe it lets you do interdictions, but it does let you hold people in place while you have that active. Unfortunately, you can't really use that without getting a crime stat at the moment, even if you are using it on an enemy target. Then at the rear here, you have some bounty pods, kind of like the Avenger Stalker, but this just has more of them. Again, that bounty hunting gameplay isn't really in the game yet either, but hopefully we'll get to see that soon as well. Alright, let's head downstairs and take a look at a few vehicles and those holo viewer models. Alright, so these are the Drake Dragonfly, and these actually are meant to be hovering, unlike the rocks that I was just taking a look at. But yeah, these are hover bikes, and they can be used both planet side and in space, and they have a slight bit of armament, dual size ones. And they're a bit awkward in terms of handling right now, but they can be useful at times. I've actually recently used them a couple of times because on new servers, it seems like there's still an issue loading in the trains and elevators to the spaceport, and sometimes you can get stuck waiting for those to load in. So I've occasionally taken the train to the commons instead and then used one of these to cross the lake over to the spaceport, which actually worked out. So yeah, I guess there are times when this is useful, and definitely in the future when ground-based gameplay becomes more useful, these will be nice to have since they can fit in a ton of ships and are pretty fast. Okay, let's take a look at those holo viewer models, and starting here we have the Corsair. The Corsair is a pretty cool looking ship. I really like how it looks, and I think it looks kind of like a Star Wars ship. It's very asymmetrical, and then in terms of its features, it's called an explorer, but it's really a medium-large sized pirate ship. It has even more weaponry than something like a Constellation, and that's saying a lot. But supposedly it's going to be slightly more sluggish too, which is also somewhat concerning. So yeah, we'll have to see what we actually end up getting once this gets put into the game. But Drake usually doesn't disappoint. Here we have the Drake Vulture. This is a bit smaller than that Corsair, and it's the small salvage ship. So we'll actually be seeing this ship pretty soon probably, as soon as they get around to getting salvage working. And this smaller ship will be probably where that profession starts out. And so yeah, I'll be excited to try out a new gameplay loop, and I know a lot of people are very excited about salvage, so I can't wait to see this ship in game. And then probably Drake's coolest ship, but the one that's going to take the longest to get put into the game. This is the Kraken, and it's Drake's carrier. This is a pretty large ship. It's nearly 300 meters long, and you can see it has a substantial flight deck here. I think each of those pads up there can fit one Cutlass-sized ship, and all of the smaller pads can fit small ships, so fighters like your Buccaneers. There's also an internal bay that can fit a small ship to repair it, or just store it there for safekeeping, and both Kraken variants have a massive amount of storage, although the Kraken Privateer gives some of that up to have some shop-like features. And yeah, these are going to be some very exciting capital ships once they're in the game. Alright, that's it for Drake's Expo display. As for the sale info, nothing has really changed except for the Caterpillar pricing, and I think that's a little bit unfortunate because you aren't really getting much more at the moment for that bump in price, and the Caterpillar is already somewhat achievable to earn in-game. So yeah, that's just unfortunate, but I guess hopefully that means that we'll be getting some more of the Cat's features implemented into the game sooner rather than later. They also haven't mentioned that either, so there's no guarantee of that. Okay, now I want to thank my members, Starjump Starlet, GreatWatch93, and Dexion Orion. Thank you guys so much for supporting the channel, and if you guys want to help me out, you can do that by hitting the like or subscribe button, or if you really want to help me out, you can become a member with the join button. I really appreciate all of you guys' support. Thanks for watching!